Hey, I'd like to show you a new way of sharing presentations. Now, let's say that you have prepared a presentation, you are ready, and you want to share it with your colleague or with your client, depending on what you work on. You want to make sure that this entire design has as little groups as possible. I would, for sharing purposes, if I want my client to edit it, go to group and ungroup certain elements of it. I'll show you why. Let's say that I have plain text boxes. I'll go to File, and under my Share options, I have the possibility, if I have a Microsoft account, which most of you surely have if you are using PowerPoint, I can share my presentation by uploading it to OneDrive. This presentation is now being uploaded to OneDrive. Absolutely do not worry if you do not have OneDrive. You can simply type in OneDrive in Google and it will take you to the link. I'm having OneDrive integrated because I'm using Office 365 subscription, but if you do not, if you have an older version of PowerPoint, you can make a completely free account and have 5 GB of storage. Why is this good? This is good because with this 5 GB, maybe you do not get access to the newest PowerPoint versions, but what you get access to, if we scroll down, is to free Office for the web's applications, which is PowerPoint for web, which is a smaller version of PowerPoint, which you can use in your browser, and web-based access. You can share access to presentations via the internet. And that's exactly what I done. I clicked on uploading it to OneDrive. Now I can copy my link. I will send this link to my client. Now this link, no matter if the client has never ever opened PowerPoint in their life, he will just enter this link into his browser. It will take a little while to load, of course, but this is only PowerPoint for web. I do not recommend this version, but if you want to share presentations, it's possible. What you can do, you can select Edit in Browser, and it will even open this web-based PowerPoint version. Do not get ahead of yourself. Currently, I do not recommend like learning this, because that's not real PowerPoint editing. Because, for example, here we have a group of items, and I basically can't do anything with that. I can just select it. But here, since I ungrouped it, the web-based PowerPoint is able to read simple text boxes. So if you would be my client, I would give you this text box. And what's cool here, I can make edits here on the web. I can change everything. And I would say, thank you very much for sending me this presentation. I can now adjust it to my liking because this is what I wanted from you. As you can see, I'm making live edits to these presentations. And those live edits are being applied here in my presentation, because this is no longer a presentation on my hard drive. This is now a presentation shared via OneDrive. Always save your presentation somewhere else before you send it to your client that way. When you're actually logging into your OneDrive, I have it currently in German, you can go to Shared, and in the Shared, you'll have this presentation in your shared files. Once you decide that you no longer want to share this presentation because you are making edits, you can simply select it, go to Sharing Options, and in the Sharing Options, you have Manage Sharing Options. Sorry that it's German now. And this link, what I had previously, I can just delete this link. Here's Delete Link. And in a matter of a few minutes, this presentation, if it will be closed, it will disappear from my shared options. Let me go back to my files, shared, and as you can see, the file is no longer here. That's what I wanted to teach you about the newest PowerPoint sharing options. That's still a topic that is changing a lot, so I'm not telling you more about this. Let's not focus on this. It's just important that you note that that exists.